Please get ready for a dictation of part two of the address by the President of India on the eve of 72nd Republic Day, New Delhi, 25th January 2021. 5 seconds. Start. Despite the serious calamity, we have succeeded in taking forward our activities in many spheres. The pandemic threatened to derail the young generation's learning process, but institutions and teachers quickly adopted new technology and ensured that there was no break in education by conducting not only free and fair but also safe elections in Bihar, which has high population density, and in union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, with difficulties of access and other challenges, our democracy and the Election Commission have accomplished remarkable feats. The judiciary found help in technology and continued to function and dispense justice. The list is long. In order to open up the economy without risking the lives of the people, the process of unlocking was carefully calibrated. This has proved effective, and the economy has started showing indications of recovery faster than anticipated. The latest unprecedented collection of GST and India's emergence as a most favored destination for the foreign investment are indicative of our faster economic recovery. The government has encouraged small and medium industries to unleash entrepreneurial spirit by providing easy loans to them and help them to come up with innovative business ideas. Dear fellow citizens, the adversities of the previous year have only reminded us of what we have always known deep in our hearts, that care and concern for humanity and the feeling of fraternity is what kept us together for millennia. In every sphere, Indians rose to the occasion and put others before themselves. We Indians live and die for humanity. This Indian great ideal has been expressed by the great poet Maithili Sharan Gupta in these words. In English, these sentiments can be broadly conveyed in the following words. It is the benevolent whose glory lives on in songs eternal. It is the generous whom the world reveres forever, whose spirit of oneness fills the boundless universe. They truly are human who die for fellow beings. I'm sure that this love for humanity and the spirit of sacrifice will take us to great heights. Let us look at 2020 as a year of learning. There were miracles of a revitalizing Mother Nature, which taught humanity a hard lesson that the small is not expedient but complementary to the big. I am sure that with a view to reducing the risk of such pandemics, the issue of climate change will be accorded top priority at the global level. Dear fellow citizens, converting a crisis into an opportunity, the Prime Minister gave a call of Atma Nirbhar Bharat Abhiyan or Self-Reliant India Mission. Our vibrant democracy, our enterprising and talented fellow citizens, especially the youth, energize our efforts in shaping a self-reliant India. The demand for goods and services in the country, the domestic efforts to meet them, and the issue and the use of modern technology in such efforts are strengthening Atma Nirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. Under this mission, steps have been taken for economic growth as well as employment generation by promoting micro, small and medium enterprises and making the start-up ecosystem more robust. It has become a movement being taken forward by the people themselves. Atma Nirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, it is in line with the aspiration of to shape a new India by the year 2022, when our country turns 75. This will be a significant milestone in the journey of the nation, as we are determined to achieve major goals from providing pakka houses with basic facilities for every family to doubling the income of farmers. In order to build an inclusive society of New India, we are giving special emphasis on education, health, nutrition, upliftment of the underprivileged and welfare of women. Adversity often plays the role of a great teacher. It makes us stronger and more confident. With that confidence, India has taken great strides in several sectors. Economic reforms have continued apace and have been supplemented by long-pending reforms in the areas of labor and agriculture through legislation. The path to reform at the initial stages may cause misapprehensions. However, it is beyond doubt that the government remains singularly devoted to farmers' welfare. Equally silent but touching more lives directly is the comprehensive reform in education, which was long overdue. The National Education Policy 2020, with its stress on tradition as well as technology, will lay the foundation of a new India which aspires to emerge as a knowledge hub on the international stage. This reform promises to incubate innate talent of students and ignite their minds to take up the challenges of life. The net outcome of all these efforts is before us. After about a year of this unforeseen ordeal, India today stands not despondent but confident. The slowdown has turned out to be transitory as the economy has regained its dynamism. A self-reliant India has manufactured its own vaccine for COVID-19 and is now undertaking a mass vaccination drive, which will be the largest exercise of its kind in history. The administration and health services are working with full readiness to make this exercise a success. I urge upon the countrymen to utilize this lifeline and get vaccinated as per guidelines. Your health opens the way for your advancement. Stop.